What's up, guys? This is Manifest. Welcome to another I'm a Fighter podcast. This is episode 45.
It's too late, it's my fate, I can't turn around. There's no fear in the mirror to hold me down.
What's up, dudes? This is Manifest. Welcome to another I'm a Fighter podcast where we want to entertain, inspire, and educate. And what a fighter isn't someone who never fails. A fighter is someone who never quits. I just got back from church earlier today. It was so good. One of the quotes that my pastor's wife actually shared was that you are not a failure unless you quit, or you can't lose unless you quit. So I shot a little video of that and just posted that on Facebook and Instagram because I was just pumped, man. I love grabbing those little tidbits and those things that just stick out to you that make all the difference. My daughter, London, is currently sleeping upstairs, so hopefully she does not wake up during this recording of this podcast. And I apologize, I missed a week the other day just because busy, man. You know, it's been a transition for me being a father now, and just with work and traveling and music and just life. But I apologize. I want to make sure I am on this every week, giving you guys inspiration, giving you encourage, because I believe in you guys. And I just want to pump you up, man, because I've been so pumped up and I've been so changed. And while I'm even recording this right now, I want to look up this scripture because it was so powerful, because I was recording something for this radio thing that I'm doing, these little inspirational minutes, and I can't remember what it is. I think it was Proverbs 4:8 or 14:8. I'm like literally looking it up as I'm recording this right now because it was just so good. And it's just talking about bitterness and how it's rottenness to the bones, but peace gives life to the body. And the reason I shared about that is because a few weeks ago my pastor was talking about how forgiveness equals freedom, and I got to bring a buddy of mine to church with me who's not a believer, who just got out of AA, and AA was encouraging him to go to church to find faith in God, because guess what? Because it works. That's why, because the Bible works. It's not just this religious ceremonies, because there's practical stuff to keep you out of trouble. And the whole thing, forgiveness equals freedom. How powerful is that? You know, to let it go, because you're not hurting the other person, you're hurting yourself. And I was just looking at the scripture the other day. It's talking about how just that whole unforgiveness is rottenness of bones. So I hope that really inspires you there. My mic just went weird there for a second. But anyways, this podcast, I just want to talk about why your dream can't wait. Why you can't wait anymore to start your dream, and why you need to start today. Not tomorrow, not in a week, not January 1st, 2015. No, today. Start your dream today. Say that with me. Today. I'm starting my dream today. Why? Because if you don't start, you will never know. And just like me, and when I quit my job years ago, I didn't want to wonder the rest of my life, what if, what if, what if. You know, there's two types of pains we can either go through, and that's either the pain of discipline or the pain of regret. And I prefer the pain of discipline. I prefer the pain of falling on my face and if I made a mistake. I'd rather the pain of rejection even. Like even walking up to my the girl who's my wife now, to be able to have the guts to call her, to be able to phone her, and sure, I might get rejected. But you know what? I'd rather know than not know. And wouldn't you rather know if this person likes you, or if you're really called to do this and put yourself on the line, at least to find out, see if you got what it takes? Have you ever wondered that? You know, do I have what it takes? I used to wonder that. Do I really have what it takes to be an artist? Do I really have what it takes to skateboard? Do I really have what it takes to even be a dad now? You know what I mean? And I don't know unless they step out and take action. You know, there is so many dreams, so many talents that go to the grave and never see the light of day. You know, I heard, I think it was Les Brown who was saying, the richest place is the cemetery, because there's so many dreams, so many songs, so many ideas, inventions that just went to the grave and never saw the light of day. You know, don't wait any longer for you to start. You know, there's still things I want to do. You know, I want to finish this course, because I launched that course, Launching Your Career as an Artist, and I'm relaunching. I've been working on it, and I want to get it done. And I don't know why. It's just something passionate about me, and I feel like if I'm going to start something, I have to finish it. And there's just something inside of you, I know, that's just begging to get out. And I want to encourage you to stop procrastinating, stop putting it off, and do it today. You know, it was Les Brown again that was saying again, like, well, the dude was on his deathbed. It was like, your dreams are calling out to you and saying, why did you not fulfill us? these talents, these giftings that were put in your hands, put in you to do, but you didn't do anything with them. You know, there's a good Bible illustration Jesus uses about the talents that he gave to different people. The one guy gave one, the other one he gave two, the other one he gave four. And the guy that only got the one, he didn't think it was good enough, so he didn't do anything with it. He just buried it. You know, do you have a talent that you just think maybe isn't good enough? That you just think, oh, it's just nothing. It doesn't really make a difference. No, it can make a difference. And once you've developed that talent, you know what? Then you can develop another one and another one. And when I see talent, I mean dream, the dream that's in your heart. Maybe you think it's too small. Maybe you think it's too big, but it's yours. And I encourage you, don't just bury it in the ground. Do something with it. Put it in the daylight. Put yourself out there. You know, I don't like getting rejected. I don't. It sucks. It hurts sometimes. You know, even putting stuff on Facebook, I still get haters and different things. And you know what? You got to just learn to brush it off. You know what I mean? I think I said in another podcast recently, the only people that don't make mistakes are people who don't do anything. And so you want to be someone who does something. You know, your dream can't wait. Don't wait to just start a New Year's resolution. Don't wait just to start your 2015 goals. No, start today. Set some goals for when this podcast is going live, which is November 23rd. Start today. You know, I'm just going to get it done. And it's, you know what's crazy? What I find is I think about things sometimes more than I act. And then when I find out I just act and do it, it's like, oh, it didn't even actually take that long. I spent more time stewing over it and like, oh, all this fear, insecurity stuff, as opposed to just doing it. And then realizing, oh, it's not even that big deal at all. Like starting this podcast this year, 2014, it was an idea for a little while. And then I was like, okay, I'm going to do it. Talk to my wife about it. So maybe you need to talk to somebody about it. Talk to a friend that's going to encourage you, that's going to support you, and say, hey, this is what I want to do. I'm doing it. Can you hold me accountable to this? Because this is my dream, man. This is my life. And have I shared with you what dreaming is? Dreaming is painting that picture of what you are and contrasting it to what you would like to become. It's painting on that blank canvas of your mind anything with no limits. You know, no limits. Only that what you put on it are the limits. God doesn't put any limits on your dreams, man. Hey, he says, if I'm for you, who could be against you? So I encourage you to paint big, paint a beautiful picture, something that's scary. You're like, whoa, this is too big that you even need God to do it. It's just so big, right? You know, what does the Bible say about faith? It's impossible to please God without faith. And God wants some big faith, man. He wants to see you do something big. Big, like crazy. You know, in 2015, I want to set a goal, something that's going to scare me, that's just so big that I got to obtain it, just to stretch me. You know, surround myself with some empire builders. I'm going to take some new courses and just grow and go big. So, hey, don't wait to start your dream another day longer. Kick fear in the face, punch it in the face, say, you are not controlling me anymore. I'm starting my dream, what? Today. Starting my dream today, not tomorrow. Today, I'm going to take action on this thing, whether I get this, whether I fall on my face. I'm going to start this thing. And you know what? I'm going to learn something through it. Because you always learn something when you're going through something, man. You always learn something. And you take that and you apply it to the next thing. If you guys haven't read my book, Fighter, 5 Keys to Conquering Fear and Reaching Your Dreams, go pick that thing up. One of the coolest things that is selling like hotcakes on our Manifest store right now is the USB skateboard key, which has all my albums. It has the Fighter audiobook and ebook on there. I think it's $25. So you get 8 albums and the ebook and audiobook. Go grab that. Give that to someone. Listen to that audiobook or pick up just the book itself on the store, 5 Keys to Conquering Fear and Reaching Your Dreams. Read it before the end of the year. You know, if you're not really into reading or whatnot, I challenge you, read it. Highlight that thing. There's action steps in there to kick fear in the face and make your dreams a reality. Man, I love you guys so much. I believe in you so much. I hope to see you on the road. I go to San Antonio, Texas tomorrow. And then I think I got an Ontario date. And then I'm going to California. I can't wait to do some surfing, get some sunshine. What's all these clouds and snow and rain? I refused to shovel my driveway last week. And guess what? I won. It rained and I didn't have to shovel it. All the snow went away. Yes. I know I'm going to have to shovel it soon, though. I probably won't always win that battle in the crazy winter we'll have. But that's okay. And then I get to go to Russia, Ukraine, and Germany. It's going to be so fun. If you listen to this podcast, make sure you come up and say hi to me and let me know that you do listen to it. And yeah, just come and say what's up and hang. I can't wait to meet you guys. Well, hey, man, you know, A fighter isn't someone who never fails. A fighter is someone who never quits. So don't you quit. Don't you ever give up until you've breathed your last breath. Do me a big favor and leave a review on this podcast on iTunes. It helps me so much. I like to know, man, like if you guys are digging this and just hearing from you, it pumps me up, man. If I'm inspiring you, hey, throw some inspiration my way and just say, hey, Chris, Manifest, love you, buddy, and appreciate what you're doing, and just give it a rating, you know what I mean? You don't have to give a 5-star. Sure, I prefer a 5-star because that helps to see it more, but just let me know what you think of this podcast and say what's up. Well, hey, I want to play for you guys my song, and it's Fighter. Hope you dig it. Peace.
It's just realness. I never knew my dad, I just hide it. I never took a class, I just write it. Sometimes I don't like what I see. Sometimes it's so hard to believe. Down it out, I start to doubt. I hit the ground, I bruise, but I won't break. I won't break. You can say I'm done, but this is just begun. On the gas, took off the mask.